Well, Paul, there are a lot of unanswered questions, really. And it was an intense and emotional time here at the school district. But I do want to point out, just in case they move, that there was a sheriff's car right here behind me. There's another one that came in just a few moments ago. One of these officers had to escort a parent outside the school district office. Many of the parents stayed at the end of the meeting to try to get more answers and see if they can get any of their questions, or really just trying to discuss the matter at hand. Again, many questions left unanswered. Many of them telling me that they showed up at today's meeting with very little notice. Normally they would get an email or notification on their app, but for this special meeting, they were given less than 24 hours notice simply by noticing that this meeting was happening on the school district agenda. That angering many people here, as you can imagine. And they showed up not knowing what the meeting was for, other than the principal of Carmel High School being on a paid leave of absence. Many people lined up to give testimonies defending that principal, and many of them really airing their grievances against the entire school district, alleging things like sexual assault, sexual harassment, bullying, and diversity problems. Again, all of that is still allegations and speculation. However, I did get some leaked documents that were from the school district, now in the hands of many parents, that giving concrete evidence that there is at least one claim that has been investigated for sexual harassment. That coming from Carmel High School, a staff member alleging that another staff member was sexually harassing them, saying things like they were easy, asking if they had a rape whistle, and also yelling just really other expletives that we can't tell you on the news, and saying that to other staff members and even a teacher's child. Now, the result, according to this investigation, according to the document, says that the recommendation was that the staff member would change their shift to something earlier. However, according to multiple parents, that staff member was transferred from Carmel High School to the elementary school here at Carmel Unified School District. Paul, back to you.
And Christian, before you go, I'm just curious here. Mr. Lyons was placed on administrative leave back in December. Here we are in February. Why is it taking so long to have this meeting and for these parents to get an opportunity to learn more about what exactly happened?
You know, Paul, that's one of the million-dollar questions. What's interesting is that the principal actually showed up to this meeting unannounced, drawing a lot of attention. I spoke to him, and he says that he doesn't really know what's going on. He was served this notice on December 16th, which forced him to lawyer up. But at the end of this meeting, what was told to the parents, as well as myself, is that he will be terminated from his current position and it changed to another location, another position, transferred off-site. What that means, I still don't know, but hopefully we can get some answers by end of day today.